I'm Mike Stanton with Build America Mutual. I'm here with BAM's Chief Credit Officer, Suzanne Finnegan. Suzanne, thanks for joining us today to talk about the CARES Act. The $2 trillion bill just passed Congress last week. It was signed by the president and provides aid to a wide swath of the U.S. economy. We want to take a couple minutes today to talk about, from a municipal credit analysis perspective, what are the important parts of the bill? So where do you start when you look at it?
So, Mike, this crisis is shaping up to be an event that's going to impact municipal budgets, both by reducing revenues and by increasing expenditures. Transit agencies have been immediately affected, and this new law provides $25 billion in direct aid to that sector. The law provides $31 billion in funding for an educational stabilization fund, including money for local school districts. And, you know, local school districts have been impacted in a variety of ways, including setting up distance learning programs, trying to develop alternative meal service plans, and providing students with the technology to participate in those distance learning programs. There's an additional $10 billion of aid for airports. And, you know, airports are typically financed by user fees. But in the face of this dramatic decline in passenger and flight volume, that's just simply not possible. There's an additional $150 billion in grants to state and local governments, but with some restrictions. And so those grants are only available to states, cities, and counties that have populations in excess of 500,000. That's a good first step, but we're going to need more. Both the National League of Cities and the U.S. Conference of Mayors have asked Congress for $250 billion to flow directly to cities of all sizes. And that is an approach that BAM has endorsed in a letter that we sent to the leaders of Congress. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi has indicated that this is a down payment, so we'll stay engaged and stay tuned to see what else develops.
Right, of course, BAM has a longstanding relationship with the National League of Cities. We are the preferred provider of insurance for their members, so we do try to work closely on issues in D.C. that affect cities and municipal issuers. And then, you know, and the other important thing I think worth noting is that the $25 billion, when you ask, you do receive. The $25 billion number for transit agencies was the number initially specified by the American Public Transit Association. So that's a strong first step, and but it does seem like the issue may be deepening.
That's right.
So beyond what was direct aid to municipal governments, what are the other implications of the bill? Because there was a lot of more traditional stimulus activity in this bill. What else are you watching?
Well, you know, so the economic outlook is so important for most sectors of the municipal market. And there's some obvious links for bonds that are secured by things like sales taxes, hotel taxes, and airport user fees. But it also applies to general obligation bonds, property taxes, and income taxes can and probably will be impacted. But that may happen over a longer time period. So the fact that there was substantial stimulus in the law is really important, and it included some provisions like the extension of unemployment benefits and insurance and cash grants to taxpayers. That's not going to replace all of the economic activity that's been suspended, but it certainly will help. And then beyond the CARES Act, it was also good to see the Federal Reserve step in to help maintain liquidity in money market mutual funds. And the new law includes some provisions that take that support even further. You know, having access to affordable financing is important for almost every issuer in the municipal market.
So we are still early in the process. There'll be a lot to follow, but thanks for joining us today to talk about what you're watching. And certainly anybody who wants to learn more about BAM and our portfolio and our approach, your team and the surveillance team put together a great FAQ about BAM municipal bond insurance and the COVID-19 pandemic. It's got information about how our portfolio breaks down and the very limited number of credits that are kind of immediately exposed to some of those issues like hotel taxes and sales taxes that you mentioned. That's available on our website so people can download it there. Thanks for your time, Suzanne.
Thank you.
Will you get paid if an earthquake puts your municipal bond investment on shaky ground? Yes. AA guaranteed. Is your municipal bond investment safe even if the next recession reduces public revenues? Yes, AA guaranteed. BAM Municipal Bond Insurance protects against everything, from natural disaster and recession to fraud or cyber attack. BAM.